telecom businesses were impacted in different ways by the COVID-19 pandemic in the first half of the year. The consumer business, on the one hand, benefited a lot from increasing demand with people working from home and online schooling, whilst on the other hand, BCX and our small and medium business were negatively impacted by the national lockdown. Corporate customers were under severe financial pressure. Small and medium businesses, restaurants, and all of those sorts of places were impacted because they had to shut down. But even with all of that, our group revenue showed quite a lot of resilience in the face of the pandemic. And I will now move on to unpack each of the businesses and how they performed even under these circumstances. Maybe let me start with group performance at a glance, and Tsulu will come in later on and unpack that further. We see that our top line has been very, very resilient. We have flat revenues, essentially, if you compare our revenues over the last 6 months with the prior period. Our profitability has improved, underpinned by our sustainable cost management programs that are ongoing. We also saw very, very strong cash generation. We moved from a negative free cash flow in the prior year to a positive free cash flow this year. We strengthened our balance sheet. Our underlying net debt to EBITDA remains stable and under control. And also we saw very, very strong earnings growth, double-digit growth in both earnings per share and headline earnings per share. Operationally, we've also seen very, very strong operational performance. Our mobile data customers grew by about 23% to 10 million. We've been really focused on how we grow our data footprint, as that's the significant view we have taken about the future. And that is also shown by how data traffic itself has grown in mobile by up to 81%, which is driven by a significant increase of people working from home and also learning from home. Insofar as hosted voice seats in the BCX environment, we've seen that go up about 260%. The pandemic drove a greater uptake in what is called hosted voice and call center applications, and we were able to provide a solution for that. Fixed line broadband traffic went up by 30%, also driven by the same factors. And we've also seen very, very steady growth in the FTTH connectivity rate. It's now about 11 points up on last year. 54% of the homes that we have passed with fiber are now connected, which actually means that we are able to remunerate our capital even better than we did the year before. And the number of mast and tower leases is up by about 11%. I will start now with consumer, and let's look at how they would have been impacted by COVID-19. And more importantly, with regards to the consumer business, is that there was a positive effect there. Mobile business benefited a lot, as I indicated earlier on, with people working from home, data usage very, very strong, demand for mobile connectivity. And remember that there was also a temporary spectrum that was assigned that enabled us to then be able to carry the increased traffic. However, on the negative side, because of the lockdown, our network rollout was a bit slow. It was not easy to get our entire supply chain to work in the way that we would have wanted it to work. And also our distribution channels were closed during the lockdown, resulting in slower handset growth. Our strategy in terms of being a data-led network continues to really, really bear fruit. If you look at the number of sites that are integrated, that has grown significantly. Leading up to COVID-19, we purposefully had executed a 70% decommissioning of 2G, freeing up the spectrum for LTE utilization and adding capacity to the network. And I think that actually helped us quite a lot to be able to carry quite a lot of the traffic that we saw in mobile. Secondly, we made sure that we aggressively roll out fiber backhaul to all of the towers that we have. That paid off as well, allowing us to effect very, very quick backhaul upgrades at sites where additional traffic was anticipated. Our data specific core capacity investment during the 3 months leading up to COVID also assisted us in establishing a baseline for further capacity expansion so that we can carry the traffic that we saw coming through. And during the COVID-19 state of emergency, we saw roughly, as I said, 80% increase in data. Network performance has improved despite the traffic increase. And we've seen that some of the media platforms have indicated that our downlink has increased by about 16% and uplink almost 45% with a 35% latency improvement. Now that effectively means our network is stable, the capacity is good, we are able to carry high-speed broadband effectively and efficiently. In parallel, we also deployed the temporary spectrum, which had been assigned by ICASA. That enabled us to continue our network expansion, increasing the number of new sites, and therefore increasing the number of LTE and LTE advanced technology in the network. And that has really supported us well. We also completed the upgrades of the existing mobile core network so that we can be 5G ready. We know that the spectrum will be allocated at some point in the new calendar year, and this allows us as Telkom to be able to seamlessly integrate the first 5G sites that we used as commercial pilots in the market earlier on. So just to close off on this slide, we chose a couple of years ago that we'll have a data-led network strategy, both in terms of how we build sites, how we look after the capacity, how we deploy massive MIMO, how we make sure that we have fiber to as many of our towers as possible, and all of that stuff is also paying back. And how is it paying back? Data has delivered quite strong growth in the period. If you look at mobile data revenue, we see a 23% increase in the broadband base to 9.6 million subscribers, which actually now makes up at least more than 70% of the overall base in mobile. So the predominant component of our base essentially is data, people who are using data, and that bears testimony to the strategy that we have deployed. At the same time, the consumer base working from home amplified the need for broadband connectivity. That was manifest by about 80% growth in traffic. And this has actually seen an exponential growth in data revenue. We have about 54% growth in data revenue now to 6 billion, and we have made quite strong inroads in the data market in the past few years. We now have closed the data revenue gap in absolute terms between Telkom Mobile and the number two player in the market. And in the future, actually, we think that's going to be a very, very important metric to look at in terms of, in absolute terms, what is the data revenue that is being generated from the network. In terms of just mobile performance, we also saw an even stronger performance from the mobile team. Their subscriber growth has grown about 19% or so, to about 14 million subscribers, with a blended ARPU increase of 37% to 113 Rand, which is the highest blended ARPU in the history of Telkom Mobile. We also saw a huge growth in prepaid, breaching the 10 million subscriber base mark and is in excess of 11 million subscribers. The mobile business continues to deliver very, very strong service revenue. We saw 47% revenue growth on last year to 8.2 billion, which is an increase of over 2.6 billion rands year on year. Our mobile EBITDA has doubled over the period as well, growing by approximately almost 2 billion rands to 2.9 billion. And it actually means that not only have we looked to access growth, but we've looked to access that growth in an efficient manner. And that has had the impact of improving our mobile EBITDA margin to about 30% in the period under review.